The two pieces to my left are sound suits that were made by Nick Cave, who's an artist that grew up near Jefferson City, Missouri, went to the Kansas City Art Institute. They're actually made to be worn, performed. One of the primary directions of the museum has always been to look to artists that have an association with Kansas City. So about 30% of our collection is made up of works by artists that either grew up in Kansas City, they were educated here, they worked here, and Nick Cave's a prime example of that. You know, a piece like this is almost futuristic, alien-like in its presence, and they are captivating. I mean, whether it's an adult or a child, when they walk into this gallery, they immediately head right for these pieces. Many American Indian artists come out of traditions of using certain materials. The piece that I'm standing adjacent to, it's a collage by Frank Big Bear, who's based out of Duluth, Minnesota. He wanted to do a work that dealt with AIM, the American Indian movement.
We are still here.
The title of the piece, We Are Still Here. They have persevered in spite of enormous hardships. Now, what's interesting is that decision that we made back in 2003 has now resulted in one of the largest and finest collections of contemporary American Indian art of any contemporary art museum in the country. Today, we probably have almost 300 major American Indian works in the collection. I think one of the great things about working with contemporary art is you're always looking to the future. You're not looking backwards, you're looking into the future and you're trying to anticipate. One of the things that we've always prided ourselves upon is that we've given emerging artists opportunities for their first institutional exhibition. And such is the case with Dana Schutz. It's a piece that Dana would tell you is derived from a luncheon that she had with some of her girlfriends. And following the lunch, she realized that they had spent the entire time discussing the women who were not with them that day. And she came to the realization, gee, when I'm not there, I wonder if they're talking about me, if my life is being dissected. And the painting is called Surgery. This is a sculpture by the artist Do Ho Sa, who largely divides his time between Seoul, South Korea, and New York City. It's called Someone. This represents someone of importance, someone of power, a dictator, an emperor. But these dog tags for Do Ho Sa represent all the people that it takes to prop up a regime.
How heavy is it?
Very. It actually comes in sections to install it, and you'd never know it because the dog tags overlap. The piece has such presence, and particularly in the evening, you know, when you don't have as much natural light in this room, it really shimmers. We started out, we were going to be 16,000 square feet, and then it grew to 41,000 square feet. And a lot of that was because in conversations with the Board of Trustees, one of the questions that was raised, is this going to be big enough? Is it really going to be region serving? Is it going to make an effect on Kansas City in the sense of it being a cultural destination? What would it take to really build something that would draw people from throughout the region, throughout the country? And that made all the difference in the world.